Today we're going to have some fun in science and explore how chemistry and Halloween relate, and some really awesome labs that you can do in the chemistry classroom that relate to Halloween. So here I have a cauldron of dry ice. That is what's creating the smoke, and we'll talk about dry ice in a few minutes. But first I want to talk about fire protection. Oftentimes when there is a fire in a area and they want to prevent the fire from spreading to other parts, they will spray the land with water. And here's what they do. This is just a regular handkerchief, and I'm going to soak it in a solution. This solution is a regular household chemical mixed with water. I'm not going to tell you what it is because I don't want you to do it at home. But regular household chemical mixed with water. And I'm going to cut the lights for a second. And I'm going to take my chemical, make sure I have water close by. This is, like I said, a regular handkerchief. And okay, you will notice that this is still a regular handkerchief. You can also do this experiment with a dollar bill. If you soak it in the solution and light it, it will also catch on fire, but will not burn, because all we're doing is burning the solution. That's something they do in a fire protection to make things not burn, like houses, things that we don't want to catch on fire. The next great Halloween activity is to take some dry ice. And when you pick up dry ice, with metal tongs, it'll actually make a screaming noise. That's because the atoms of the metal are actually freezing. They get so cold that they start to freeze. This dry ice is incredibly cold. You don't want to touch it, and you want to make sure that everyone knows the safety precautions and not to touch this dry ice. But I'm going to take this dry ice. I've already added it to this mixture, so I'm going to add it to this beaker right here. This beaker is just filled with water, and you'll see that when we add it to the water, it starts to make a similar foaming to the one that we have in this cauldron. And now I'm going to take a mixture of soap and water, and I just have it on handkerchief again, and wring it out a little bit. I'm going to take this mixture and I'm going to try and form a bubble over the top of my beaker, lightly over the top of this beaker. I'm going to try and form a bubble as I go. There we go. And you will see that it is creating a big giant bubble. That's from the gas of the the dry ice sublimating. It goes directly from a solid to a gas. That's called sublimation. And when we go from that solid dry ice to the gas, it will actually form a big giant bubble. There we go. The dry ice, if you place it on a piece of paper, will not form a wet spot like a regular ice cube will, which is one of the cool things about dry ice, because it is so cold and it goes directly from that solid to gas state. The next thing you can show your students is that when you add some bubbles to this dry ice, you'll actually get some really awesome bubbles. If you pop the bubbles, they will form big giant smoke balls. So that's really cool. Another cool use for dry ice on a Halloween day. So that is dry ice. The next thing that I want to show you about dry ice is one of its properties. Water, as you know, has a pH of 7. It is our neutral. I'm going to add some pH indicator to this water, and you will see that it has turned a nice blue color. Stir that around a little bit. Let's add a little bit more. Okay, it's a nice blue color right now. I'm going to take this indicator. So you see the blue. I'm going to take the indicator, I'm going to add some dry ice to it. And here we go. And just give it a second. and you will see that the indicator has actually changed from that blue color to a green color. Now it's starting to change to a yellowy red color. That is because the dry ice is an acid. So we're seeing that nice yellow color there. Another great lab is to take a beaker full of water and a beaker full of acetone and put the styrofoam cup, just a regular styrofoam cup that you would get at the grocery store, in the beaker of water and ask the students to observe it. Write down what they observe and then tell them to do the same with the acetone. The acetone actually starts to eat away at the styrofoam cup and dissolve the cup. That is because the acetone and the styrofoam cup are both nonpolar bonds. Therefore, like dissolves like, and we get the dissolving of the cup. So it's a great way for you to teach like dissolves like, or polar bonds dissolve polar bonds, and nonpolar dissolve nonpolar in a fun and interesting way. Fits in great with Halloween because you're making foam and dissolving these cups. Last private lab that I like to do is taking cornstarch and water, making slime. I take about half a cup of cornstarch, a fourth a cup of water, mix the two with some food coloring, and then you let the students get their hands dirty. If they mix the two substances together, they will actually eventually form slime. Okay, and you'll see that after I've mixed it for a while, I form a slimy goo. Depending on the amount of cornstarch and water you add, you'll get a different consistency. If you want a drier solution, add more cornstarch. If you want a more liquidy solution, add more water. But then the thing I like to have the students do is once they have this slime, to figure out if they have created a liquid gas or a solid, which state of matter their substance is. Because this substance takes the shape of its container, you'll see that it sits in the bottom of its container. It is a liquid. And that is how we determine what state of matter it is in. Those are my spooky science labs, and I hope you have an awesome Halloween.
I ain't afraid of no ghosts.